So I first really got enamored with space watching the STS-1 launch in 1981. My grandfather was a sixth grade science teacher at the Milton Hershey School in Pennsylvania. And he was just so excited to be able to share the science stuff with me and really, really encouraged aviation. My grandmother bought me gift certificates for flying lessons. So every year for Christmas, I would get 3 flying lessons. And that just kind of kept that fan going. Just having those experiences along the way that just kept me excited about it and just opened the door to all new possibilities and things that I could see. You know, it wasn't just one path, it was a whole industry of things in this passion that I have with aviation. A failure to me sounds a lot like the end of a path. But if you don't accept it as that and you accept it as a, hey, well, we learned something there, or I learned something on that part, and I can take this diversion to a different path and use what I learned as I continue to move forward, then I think that is really the way I handled most things in my life. Find something you're really passionate about and that you really enjoy and go after that. And don't be afraid of failure. Be willing to take different risks along the way. And just enjoy the process and the journey that you're on, because you're the only one who gets to take that journey of your own life. Having a bad day, obviously that's one of those things that's going to happen. I think just taking it in stride, stepping back, I think perspective is a really important thing. When we're on space station, yes, we have bad days while we're operating the space station, but stepping back and realizing what a privilege it is to be up there and finding the things that are still good, even if you're having a bad day, going and looking out the window at the Earth, that is still a good thing. And so finding those silver linings out there amidst the bad day is really helpful and helps you get through it. And then the nice thing is there's always a new day around the corner.